Hey, welcome back to Play and Trade Guitars. I'm John, that's Zach behind the camera, and this is Play and Trade Guitars, where we play it and trade it. We've got a great new collection from Epiphone. This is the Inspired by Gibson Custom Electric Collection. We're gonna be looking at all of them on the channel. Today, let's take a look at the new 1959 Les Paul Standard. This is kind of like the new and improved take, because actually this collaboration with Gibson Custom kicked off a few years ago with an SG Les Paul and the 59 Les Paul that they did at that time. I'll tell you why this one's better. I'll tell you everything you need to know about this new guitar. We'll put it on the bench and pull it apart, talk full specs before we plug it in and play it. But at the top, if you're in the market for this guitar or any gear, click to buy that new gear using our link. You'll find that pinned in the comments or down in the description. You help us make these videos when you buy new gear using our link, so thank you. In the States, you're gonna get fast free shipping, easy payment plans. In Europe, you can use our Toman link down below as well. Also, be in it to win it. We're giving away an American-made Martin acoustic guitar when we hit 100,000 subscribers. To win that guitar, make sure you're subscribed. Hit subscribe now, turn on notifications, and enter via Gleam, all that down below. Without further ado, let's take a first look at the brand new, the new and improved 1959 Les Paul Standard in the Inspired by Gibson Custom Collection from Epiphone. All right, so we covered the first generation of this Gibson Custom collaboration for the 1959 Les Paul Standard. You can watch that video on our channel. That's still available at $999. Now, this guitar is $1,299. It's more expensive, and let me just give you a few of the highlights that set this one apart. First of all, most strikingly obvious, you have the Gibson open book headstock on this guitar, which I think looks really cool. Now, just like the other edition, you have a Laurel fretboard. However, check this out. You've got beautiful mother of pearl trapezoid inlays. That's actually more souped up than even like a Les Paul Standard from Gibson USA, which would be acrylic. You have true mother of pearl and they really shine. They look absolutely beautiful. I also think Laurel feels a lot like rosewood, so I think from a playability standpoint, that doesn't bother me much. This is another big headline here. These are custom buckers. This is like a $500 set of humbuckers that they put in this guitar. Amazing. It used to be you couldn't even buy the custom buckers separately. Gibson offers that now. But for Epiphone to be incorporating actual custom buckers into this guitar, I think is awesome. They've done a lot of other cool things. They've got a medium 59 profile C-shaped neck. They've got a long neck tenon, period correct ABR tailpiece. A lot of great things. They've even got etched, I'll show you on the bench a little bit closer. They've got this cool new kind of dual diamond etching on the back of the headstock for the Gibson Custom collaboration. And they just went the extra mile. They got this R9 Gibson style headstock and the works. So let's head to the bench and pull it apart, talk full specs. Pretty excited about this one. Feels good in the hands already. I like that neck shape. Let's go see where it measures out. Star of the show here, open book Gibson style headstock, Les Paul model screened in gold. You've got these Epiphone Deluxe double line vintage style tuners. And then check out how they're doing this new Inspired by Gibson etching here, just to set the series apart, which I think looks great. Now they put a lot of time into getting the C-shaped medium neck profile right for a 59. You can see the binding. It's got 22 frets, and check out these mother of pearl inlays against the Laurel fretboard. Those inlays get me every time. They look really stunningly beautiful. And then in terms of this flame top, they are using a veneer, which you otherwise have a traditional mahogany body, maple carved top, and a few finish options available. You can click our link to see the three finish options available for this guitar, but it looks really good. One thing I will point out about the finish, they're calling it, I think this is confusing as heck, they're calling it VOS, which means something totally different at Gibson Custom, Vintage Original Sheen. And what they mean by that, this is a Vintage Original Sheen finish, and the best way to describe that, it's kind of like a semi-gloss. It's like semi-matte. It's somewhere between gloss and satin. And it's more of a kind of satin feel, particularly on the neck. It's somewhere in between, but it won't look as strikingly gloss as like a Les Paul Standard. Just keep that in mind. And the other star of the show, like I said, you got this set of Gibson custom buckers. These are PAF style humbuckers. They sound fantastic, and they're an expensive set of pickups in this guitar. They've got all sorts of other vintage appointments, ABR1 style bridge. So let's get the strings out of the way and get a few measurements. Nut comes in at 1.68 inches. First fret at 0.87 inches, up to a 12th fret of 0.97 inches. So on the chunkier 50s style, but 59 kind of Goldilocks, not too fat, not too skinny, medium C-shaped profile there. 1.92 inches thick on the body. So you've also got this vintage style and correct aluminum, super lightweight tailpiece. And then you got this correct ABR1 bridge with the screws up there on the posts. And they do have post into the bushings on this one, which makes it a little bit more stable, a little bit more easy to adjust. Let's flip over these custom buckers and take a look. And right away, you'll notice that long neck tenon here used in construction. You can see marked custom bucker on the back, PAF, patent applied for sticker. Some of my favorite pickups, they sound fantastic. And then flipping on the multimeter, we'll go ahead and get a reading. 7.5 in bridge, 7.7 in neck, 3.8 combined. Control cavity cover has this nice gold embossed Epiphone and Gibson Custom. Lifting that up, under the hood we have 50 style wiring, CTS pots, 500K, and Mallory caps in here. 8 pounds, 8 ounces, 8.5 pounds, great weight for a Les Paul. All right, flipping it around for initial reaction, I'll tell you what it feels like and looks like is a Les Paul. And they did a really knockout job in the Epiphone line, making this feel right. I think that the neck shape, yeah, it feels great. It's a perfect kind of medium shaped 50 style profile neck, 59 profile neck. Everything feels great. And definitely a standout feature to point out is that it's got more of that kind of satin feel. And it's somewhere in between. It's kind of like a semi-gloss, I would call it. They're calling that the vintage original Sheen. Just to have another confusing acronym for VOS that we can't agree on. But I'll tell you what, this guitar feels fantastic. Remember, if you're in the market for this guitar, click to buy it using our link, you help us. Now comes my favorite part. We're gonna plug this in. I'll show you clean tones, we'll dirty it up, and then let it scream behind a track. Join me on the other side. I'll give you my raw, honest reaction to playing this guitar along with a final score. So drop a comment as we go. Let's get plugged in and let it rip.
Thank you.
right, what'd you think? Epiphone's take on the quintessential 1959 Les Paul Standard. Truly a legendary guitar. Done in collaboration with the Gibson Custom Shop. I really like what they did here. This is kind of like their 59 Standard 2.0 because they did this already, but they've souped it up primarily with that open book Gibson headstock, mother of pearl inlays, beautiful neck feel on this guitar, great C medium 59 profile, and these custom buckers are where it's at. They sound really good. You stuck with me to the end, so I'll give you my final score. I based that on three categories: overall playability, overall sound, and overall value. Kicking it off with playability, I love the shape of this neck. If you know me, you know that I like a 50 style neck. They can get extra thick though sometimes. This is that perfect Goldilocks medium, that legendary 59 neck profile, and I think they nailed this one. As they'll tell you, this is the same neck profile they use on the Custom Shop R9s. Beautifully executed, it feels fantastic. I'll also tell you, when it comes to playability, this finish, which they're calling the vintage original sheen, which is kind of like a semi-matte or semi-satin, semi-gloss kind of a thing, very comfortable. Somewhere in between gloss and satin. That's just the best way I can describe it, and it didn't get in my way at all. The setup from the factory in this guitar, the strings came a little bit high, so all I did was lower those down to my liking. I gave the truss rod a slight tighten, but you know, in transit, these are gonna come to you, and depending on where you are, what your climate is, you're gonna need to have a little bit of setup done out of the box. But I did that and it feels fantastic. So overall playability, I'm gonna give this a high score of 9.2 on overall playability. When it comes to sound, the custom buckers sound fantastic. They have a velvety, singing, kind of rich voice to them that nails the PAF thing. And if you're into blues rock or anything in that vein, I mean, you cannot go wrong with these custom buckers. These are high-end pickups that you'd find in a custom shop guitar. In this guitar at $1,299. Overall sounds, I got a lot of great textures, a lot of great voicings, a lot of great ideas and sounds. It just didn't get in my way and it sounded fantastic. I'll go ahead and give it a 9.2 on overall sound. When it comes to value, these are now $1,299. They do include a hardshell case. You're getting the custom buckers, you're getting the Gibson style headstock, which is a big deal. And it is $300 more than the existing Epiphone 1959 Les Paul Standard, but I do think you're getting your money's worth. I guess one tip is, I don't know what they're gonna do with the other iteration of this guitar. Will they discontinue it? We'll find out. You can grab that one at $999. That's a fantastic guitar. This one you will be buying because you recognize the additional value of the custom buckers, and particularly this open book headstock. It really makes it, it really brings it home as the 1959 Les Paul Standard overall package. And overall value, I'm happy with what I'm seeing here. I'm happy with what I'm feeling and hearing. I'm gonna go ahead and give it a 9.0 on overall value. I'm also really happy that these didn't come out at a higher price tag of like $1,699 or something. The fact that these are coming out at $1,299, I think they did it just right. I'm impressed with that. 9.0 overall on value. That brings us to an overall score for the Epiphone Inspired by Gibson Custom 1959 Les Paul Standard of 9.1. Great score for a great guitar. I enjoyed this one a lot. It's also a great weight, 8.5 pounds. This one, they nailed it here. I'm really, really happy with this guitar. If you're gonna buy this, click to buy using our link. It really does help us. You get those great benefits too, and be in it to win it with our Martin giveaway when we hit 100,000 subscribers. To win that guitar, you've got to hit subscribe now if you haven't, turn on notifications, and enter via Gleam. All that sign up information and the purchase link for this guitar, you can check out the other finishes. All that's down below or pinned in the comments. For Play and Trade Guitars, I'm John. Check out our other videos on the guitars in this series. Everything from the Firebird to the 335 to the Les Paul Custom, which looks fantastic. Check out those videos next. Thanks for watching. See you next time.